first of all, I 100% agree with you. And that's the thing, you know, when people say she died of cirrhosis of the liver, I mean, she did die, but, you know, one of the things they would say is they'll give her enough rope to hang herself. So Billie Holiday mm-hmm. wanted to get clean, you know what I mean? And she made efforts and she made strides to get clean, but she had the entire government setting her up, trying to get her to kill herself, you know? And so yeah. I think that's the part we need to learn, especially the subtleties, right, of oppression, the subtleties of this type of assassination. You know what I mean? It's not, it can't be overt. You can't just, you know, kill her in a very obvious way. And so, you know, J. Edgar Hoover, people like Harry J. Anslinger, they were masters at sort of pinpointing whatever your weakness was and then exploiting that, you know, unto the death of too many of our leaders. And so I'm so glad that you brought that up, because, you know, a lot of people will maybe still think, oh, well, she was troubled and she was a drug addict and that's why she died. I'm like, no, she was like any other person with an illness, you know, and yeah. was trying to cope with her trauma. And she had such a world of it. Also, you know, again, this woman was, she was raped at, you know, 10, 11 years old. She was punished, sent to a reform school for being raped by, you know, a 40 plus year old man. And then she was sent into a brothel, you know, by her mother at a very young age. She lost her father to Jim Crow. Then she loses her mother. She has no family. And she's seeing this racial terror take place in America, and she's unsettled. She's trying to live as a Black queer woman in the 30s, 40s, and 50s. So you almost ask yourself, how could she have possibly done this without some type of battery in her back like that, you know? And so, but I think this is why this movie is so important, is that we have to tell the truth about her narrative and we have to stop allowing our narratives to continue to be suppressed and to be changed to, I always say, to limit the scope of our struggle and our contribution and our triumphs, you know? So
yeah.
I'm really glad you brought that up, because the narrative has now changed now that the opioid addiction is, quite frankly, affecting more young white kids, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Now it's a problem. Now right. It needs to be solved. Before, it just needed to be prosecuted, you know?